Good morning, everyone. So today we will be doing experiments on efficiency and performance of a Pelton turbine. So let's take a look on the parts of the equipment that we're going to use. So we have one miniature of a Pelton turbine here. So as you can see, we have a spear bucket here. Okay. So these are the parts of the Pelton turbine. So this is the architecture. And then we have two spring scale or spring balance. So you have left and right. So here, so this is the sample of the blade of our Pelton turbine. So it's just like a bucket here, so two buckets. So the water is heating this blade to run the turbine. Then we have here the valve. So the spear valve. So this will control the water inlet. So the water inlet heating the bucket of the turbine, so the turbine blades, okay? So it can control from 100%, 50%, 25% of the water inlet, okay? So also we have one pressure gauge here wherein we can measure the water pressure at the inlet, okay? Before it hits the turbine. So we have one pressure gauge here in millibar. Okay. So backside here, as you can see, we have here the brake drum. So this brake drum, the diameter of this brake drum is 25 millimeter. So 25 millimeter. On the brake drum, we put one silver strip. So this silver strip we'll use to measure the speed of our turbine when it is running. So we have one tool to measure the speed, which is the tachometer. So this instrument, this measures the speed of our tachometer. So we'll be using this during the experiment. Okay. So the first step is to switch on the hydraulic bench. So we'll be using hydraulic bench. So pump control. So to switch on the hydraulic bench, just press the black button here. The black button. And the pump will run, okay? Then open the hydraulic bench gradually, okay? So this will control the water inlet. So open this valve gradually, and then the spear valve here, the black one. So you need to open it slowly until it becomes fully open. Until it becomes fully open, so at 100%, okay? At 100% speed, 100% opening of the valve, we can measure the speed of our turbine. So as you can see here, we have no load. We have no load. Okay? Left and right balance will be on zero. Will be on zero. So we can adjust the load by adjusting this screw at the top. Okay? By adjusting the screw on the top. So for the first trial, take the reading, left and right balance will be zero. The pressure will be, the pressure of our water at the inlet is 300, okay? 300 millibar. 300 millibar at full speed and full opening of the spear valve, okay? So this is our reference point. Then the next trial is to slowly increase the load. So in steps to give you at least 6 sets of results. 6 sets of results, we will apply a load. So at each step, the speed and the reading of each spring balance. So stop when the speed becomes unstable or zero. So how to adjust the load? So at first this one, we will apply now a load to our turbine. So adjust from the left balance. So this is the next trial, okay? So I will take my reading now. So at left, I have 2, okay? And here I have 3.5, okay? 3.5 newton. So take the difference and multiply it into 25 millimeters diameter of the drum. So this will be the reading on our left and right balance. Then again, take the reading on the pressure. So still I have 300, okay? 300 at the water inlet. So that is my pressure. And then let me measure the speed. So pointing the tachometer into the silver strip. So this is how we are going to measure the speed. So I have 777, okay? Maximum speed. So you can just press this red button and hold. Take the maximum. So 7.78, okay? Then take your reading. So you have the speed in revolution per minute. You have the reading in left balance. So the unit will be in Newton. Calculate the load. So the load is the torque, okay? So the power, how you will calculate the power? So this 2 pi nt divided by 60. So the unit will be in watts. So the efficiency, how are you going to calculate the efficiency? So mechanical power divided by hydraulic power multiplied by 100. How are we going to calculate the hydraulic power? The hydraulic power will be the product of our volume flow rate and the pressure at the inlet. So we have 300 millibar for the pressure multiplied by the flow rate given by the hydraulic bench. So take the reading. So you have in liters per minute. So for this trial, so you have 22.5 liters per minute. You'll get the hydraulic power. So again, for the next trial, increase the load. Increase the load. So pull this up, pull this up. Rotate the nut in clockwise direction and you are increasing the load, okay? Then take the reading. Take the reading. Left balance, right balance. The unit will be in Newton, okay? So do this procedure for at least 6 sets of readings. 6 sets of readings, okay? So these 6 of readings, we will take the graph of this at the end of the experiment. Okay, so once you complete the experiment, release the load, switch off the pump, and close the spear valve and the hydraulic bench. Okay, so in the rest of the experiment will be plotting the graph and the conclusion. Okay, so this will end the experiment on the efficiency and performance of a Pelton turbine.